Stoffer.
Today, Moscow is a metropolis of over 11 million people. But 800 years ago, it was a small village on the banks of the Moskva River. A modest settlement surrounded by simple wooden defenses. It gave little indication of its future greatness or its ability to evolve through adversity. Moscow was frequently attacked and destroyed. Yet each time, it rose from the ashes, stronger and better defended. Its first real test came in 1238. This time, they faced a new enemy, the Mongols. Moscow had been largely unaware of the growing threat in Central Asia. Genghis Khan, founder of the Great Mongol Empire, had conquered most of the Asian continent. His descendants continued his work to expand the empire. His grandson, Batu Khan, led the armies of what would become known as the Golden Horde. Their goal, to extract money from principalities they conquered. One by one, states in the region, known collectively as the Rus, fell to the Golden Horde. Moscow was next. In 1238, the Mongol Golden Horde surrounded Moscow and besieged its wooden walls. It would only hold out for 5 days. Moscow burned. That could have been the end of its story, but the people of Moscow were resilient. They would not give up their home or their control of the Moskva River, an important trade route. They began to rebuild and strengthen Moscow's defenses. Yet one question remained. Would the terror return?
We will kill every Mongol we face. Kill, destroy, bad. Did this question.
Moscow faced certain ruin as Mongol raiders burned their way through the wooden city. With no other Rus coming to their aid, it was up to the people of Moscow to drive away their attackers and beat out the flames.
Готовы, если мы. Исправляю.
Подыщите, готовы.
The remaining Mongols were driven away by the tenacious Muscovites. With the Mongol raiders repelled and the fires extinguished, the Muscovites began rebuilding. The Muscovites knew that they could rapidly construct buildings out of wood, and so gathered what they needed from the forest.
Слушайте.
Варевник. Ага. Позорота есть, да? Да. Числа?
The woods surrounding Moscow provided an abundance of resources, but danger lurked within. Predators stalked in the shadows looking for an easy meal.
Да.
Several villages had fled during the Mongol attack, and some were still in hiding. The fleeing villagers had taken refuge in forest hunting cabins. Here, the Muscovites could bring valuable animal pelts, which provided them a good livelihood. As the city rose from the ashes, the Muscovites would lay the foundations for a unique fortified complex. This iconic structure would be known as the Kremlin. The once unassuming village of Moscow had been rebuilt as a city poised for growth. But to protect the city from further Mongol raids, it would need a fierce military and a strong defensive perimeter. The Muscovites knew that the terror from the steppe could return at any time.
Добро есть.
Наказом следую. Сделаю.
Слушайте. Идти надо бы.
Убираю древеса. Паревник готов есть. Ладно, я.
Готова работать.
Готов трудиться есть.
Я построю сие.
Having been caught off guard by the Mongols before, the Muscovites knew they could come under attack at any moment. Strong defenses would give them a better chance of protecting their city.
Есть.
Мирно трудитеся!
Тримайтеся!
Приуготовляйтеся всі! Начну трудитеся!
Копейщицы, грядите!
Приуготовляйтесь, пси!
Добудьте на весах!
Накази будут!
Здорово!
Уразумею!
И тебе повиную!
Hearing the foreboding beat of the Mongol war drums, the Muscovites braced themselves for another raid.
Приуготовляйтесь!
Во мне!
Слушайте, копейщица в ряде, ясно есть. Исправляйтесь. Соглашаемся.
The Muscovites had successfully defended their newly built city against the Mongol raid. Now that Moscow could defend itself, its rulers looked to expand their influence into new territories.
Moscow, Moscow.